Hi, I'm John McGivern. You know what we're going to do? We're going to take a tour, like a little pub crawl of Milwaukee's favorite Irish pubs. I have had the great fortune of going to Ireland 4 times in the past 2 years, and these are things I don't miss. On Thursday night, I'm always at Jimmy the Mill, which is a pub outside the little village of Upper Church in County Tipperary. On Fridays, I'm always at Ryan's Pub, which is in County Tipperary as well, in the town of Nina. And I never miss a lunch at Andy Flynn's, which is a pub in Nina as well. What we're going to do is look at these pubs in Milwaukee and see how they compare to the pubs in Ireland. What is the sisterhood of the pubs in Milwaukee and the pubs in Ireland? This is going to be great fun. You're watching MPTV. It's the only place on your dial. It's the only place on your remote that will give you this kind of programming. Let's go. Let's have fun. We're at Moe's Irish Pub. We're on the corner of Plankinton and Wisconsin. This place is famous for a few things. It's famous for being incredibly authentic inside. It's got great food, great spirits, and incredible live music. Here we are, first stop, Moe's Irish Pub with Johnny V, the owner. How are you?
Great. It's good to see you.
Great seeing you.
How's it going? Congratulations.
Oh, thank you very
much. On this place,
your
Moe's in Wauwatosa.
Amazing.
It's going well, isn't it?
Yeah, it's really great to be out there.
Why Moe's? What's Moe mean?
My mom's name is Maureen.
Shut up.
She's 100% Irish.
From what county?
County Cork.
Good.
And her nickname is Moe, so we've named all the restaurants after her, and it's great. She's very happy, very proud.
So. I have a sister, Maureen. We call her Moe.
See, exactly.
I have a sister, Colleen. Call her Colleen.
Nice. Nice. Yeah. Not Co.
No. Nice. I don't want to. She's like, shut up.
We're here with Tracy Conan. She said she eats here, and I said, what are you eating? And what did you tell me?
Fish and chips.
Why?
Because it's Friday and it's Lent.
It's Friday and it's Lent. And do you like coming to this place?
I love the fish and chips. Love coming here.
You do?
Absolutely.
Are you Irish?
No.
Shut up, you look it.
I know. Everyone tells me I'm Irish, but I'm really not.
Well, good. Enjoy your fish and chips.
Thank you.
Well, when we were designing the bar, I really liked the Temple Bar in Dublin. There was a whiskey bar in the back, and so we took a bunch of pictures. And I just happen to have one right here. And
I made him bring it.
And so this is the picture that we gave to the architects to then design the bar that's right there.
It's great. They did a good job.
They did a great
this
job.
This place is great.
Oh, thank you
and
so much.
And you've done a good job.
And you're great too, John.
Thanks. Hug me. There we go. Thanks. Good to see you.
Thanks.
Thanks. Here we go. We're on Astor at Juno in downtown Milwaukee in a residential neighborhood that's full of houses and condos. And nestled among this neighborhood is County Clare. County Clare, which is not only a pub, but a full service restaurant and a guest house, almost a B&B. Let's go in and check out County Clare, okay? Looks great. We're here with Greg. Greg's the bartender and he taught me how to pour a Guinness. This is called a proper Guinness, is that right?
This is a proper pint, yes, as you'd find it in Ireland. Basically, it's a two-part pour. Guinness is required to rest before you finish up the second portion of the pour.
Well, who isn't? You know what I mean? Rest before the second portion.
Right, but not when you drink it.
Is that right?
There's no rest at all when having a pint. You can drink as many as you like, as fast as you like.
If you took a moment to talk about County Clare to anybody, mm-hmm. what would you say?
County Clare is a lovely spot. We always think of it as kind of the embassy. When you step into the foyer, you step into the room. We think of it as an embassy to Ireland and Irish hospitality. And the stained glass and the natural fireplace and the history of the walls and the history of the stained glass and all of the Irish sayings that we have really are great examples of being in Ireland and the quaintness and quietness and comfort of Ireland.
We stepped out from behind the bar, and Greg is nice enough to give us a little tour around the place. Greg, what do we got here?
Well, I just wanted a point of interest. This is called the St. Snug, and snugs in Ireland are very, very common, and back in the olden days, they used to be reserved for the families to meet as a gathering place where generally the men would meet at the bar and discuss politics. Women and children would meet in the snug. We also have all of the sins opposing the saints, so we kind of deem this as its own entity. Anything can happen in this area, so.
Now we're talking about sins? You know it's Irish.
How cool is the shamrock?
That's a Guinness. It's a proper pour. County Clare, downtown Milwaukee.
Ooh. Hey, we're on Juneau, between water and the river, at the Harp. The Harp is one of the oldest Irish pubs in the city. It's got a great patio, which we can't experience today because it's kind of chilly. But let's go in and see what's going on, okay? The Harp on Juneau. Hey guys, how are you? It's 10 to 4. What are you guys doing here? What are you talking about?
We're talking about the Brewers.
Are you?
Yep.
How are they doing so far?
Well, so far it's been a good year.
What are you drinking?
I have a Guinness.
The Guinness?
Yep.
Do you know how to pour a proper Guinness?
I left that up to that guy.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
We're with Mitch Wakefield. We're at the Harp. His family has owned this since when?
1979.
And the bar's been here since when?
There's been a bar here since the mid-20s. It's been the Harp since the mid-50s.
Everybody knows the Harp. It's probably the oldest Irish pub in the city, or at least people know, that people know of.
I think that's fair to say.
And I love the fact we were talking before, and you said that people leave town and they come back, and it's like the Harp is still here. It's like coming home, isn't it?
I think it's kind of a frame of reference for a lot of people. They go and they're here for their college years, spend a little time here, make some memories, and they go off and do their thing either in Milwaukee or elsewhere, and they're always happy to come back here and see that it's here, and that I think they gauge how much Milwaukee's changed to some degree by places like this and whether they've survived and succeeded or whether they've gone away.
What makes it Irish?
It's Irish heritage in my family, as well as a lot of the decor, and we try to keep that Irish pub spirit here, which is friendly camaraderie. Everybody talks to one another, whether they know each other or not.
Emily, do you know these guys?
No. I've never seen them before.
They just sat next to you? Are you into it? Who do you like so far?
None of them.
We're at the Harp. It's downtown Milwaukee. It's the oldest of the Irish pubs. It's great to be here. Thanks, you guys.
Thank you.
It's that North Avenue bar scene, east side of Milwaukee, UWM students, a lot of east side people. It's Patty's Pub. Let's go in and check it out, okay? Come on. Woody, come on in. Introduce Patty, please.
This is my lovely wife, Patty. She's actually the brains behind this outfit.
Are you the brawn? Is that how that
works? Yes, I am.
Yeah?
Yes, I am.
Congratulations. How's it going?
Great.
Is it going well? How long have you been here?
11 years.
11 years. Mm-hmm. It's a great place. You know, I was talking to a friend of mine about coming here today to do this, and this is what my friend said. M&M's and peanuts, as much as you want at the bar. If somebody said, give me a moment and tell me about Patty's, what would you tell them?
I would tell them it's absolutely one of my favorite places. It's so welcoming and warming, and you just feel like you're at home. Everyone wants to talk to you and have a great time.
Even Woody?
Even Woody.
Really? Really? He's scaring me, that SMPD guy. And Patty's great, isn't she?
Oh, Patty. I've known Patty forever.
Is she fun?
Yes.
That's good. Take a look at these doors. They're over 100 years old, aren't they?
Oh, yes. That they are.
I love your little pew.
Oh, yes. We do have a lot of church artifacts.
This is the middle room of how many rooms?
I never stopped to thought about it. We got 1, 2, 3, 4.
Woody,
five.
The questions are going to get tougher.
Oh,
okay, just so you know.
Six. We got about six different rooms here. Yes.
Woody, let's take a walk into the front room.
Okay.
This is great. Beautiful stained glass. A bar. How old is this?
The bar is approximately 1925, the closest I can date it. It's all hand-carved oak. You can tell by looking at it. You see the ruffles in the wood. It's not as smooth.
It's a great room. This is the front room, and this is the room where you don't smoke. It's a non-smoking room at Patty's Pub. I think it's great. So Woody, we're gonna go upstairs. This is the piece de resistance, so they say. It's an incredible upstairs here at Patty's Pub on Murray. It's wild.
And there's a little bit of history all over here. One of the things that I'm quite proud of is that there's a shelving that goes all the way across around the top here.
Uh-huh.
I salvaged that from Colt's Restaurant over in Oakland when that when they redid that place years ago. We have a live band almost every Friday and Saturday night here.
Great.
If you can't have a good time here, you shouldn't be out drinking.
There you go.
There you have it. Some of Milwaukee's favorite Irish pubs. You need to realize that there's others to explore. Go out there and explore them in this city that we call home. Milwaukee Public Television is happy to take you all over the world to experience the culture and traditions and the livelihood of the people of these regions. You need to realize that your annual contribution helps us for future programming. So visit mptvfriends.org or call the number on the screen to give us your annual contribution. We appreciate it. I'm John McGivern. This has been great fun. We'll see you again.